So to continue.
And we're back!
Yeah.
And we're gone!
What I was saying is, like, even though the Switch has a game worth buying at launch, I can't forgive that its lineup is still thin.
Half its lineup is nothing but ports of games we had already on different consoles.
Literally, not counting indies, there were only 5 retail launch games. And I can name them.
And they were?
1-2 Switch and Breath of the Wild were the first party ones. Then it was Super Bomberman R, Just Dance 2017, and Skylanders Imaginators.
Were those games even received well?
I heard Imaginators, like, it was nice, to have, like, the digital, to have the console version on the go, since the previous handheld versions of Skylanders were much different than the console versions.
Yeah.
I could be mistaken. You know more about it than I do, were they?
Yeah, actually, every handheld version of Skylanders has been different from the console versions.
So people are saying it's...
Hell, the handheld versions didn't even have chaos.
People are saying that it's nice to have the console versions of the Skyland of a Skylanders game on what is essentially a handheld, and having the digital Skylanders, even though it loses something because there's no toys, it's still nice and it's convenient.
You know what really pisses me off, though?
Mm-hmm.
Is that this particular version of Skylanders does not require toys. Jeez, thanks for telling me that after I bought 10,000 fucking toys, you know?
Well, I mean, we already have the game, so it doesn't really matter to
us. Yeah, it doesn't matter to us, but at the same time, if you can do that with this game, in particular, for this console, why couldn't you do that to begin with? You could have saved me thousands of dollars.
Other than that, from what I heard about the other two games, Just Dance 2017, I was seeing some reviewers give it a higher score than they gave to 1-2 Switch. Make of that what you will. And then for Super Bomberman R, I heard a lot of people say that it would, like, it probably should have been, like, an eShop game.
Ooh.
Some people were, like, not even that it was, like, poorly made, it's just, like...
A budget game, pretty much.
Yeah, it really wasn't worth, like, a full price buy. And that's a shame, because it's been forever since we've seen Bomberman. And I kind of fucking called that you missed it. And you could have had it.
Excuse me, can we cut one more time? I have to use the restroom.
Really?
Yes, really. Excuse me.
Fuck.
Okay, I'm properly emptied. I can see out my eyeballs again, but...
As I was saying, it also kind of sucks that Super Bomberman R turned out to be just eh. Because I fucking called that they were going to show it at the Switch reveal, and I was going to hold that W forever.
But then you saw the game that came out.
But now it kind of feels like, oh, congratulations, you called that they were going to show it. So what? It's not like you called that they were going to show Metroid or some shit. It's like you called, oh, they're going to show Bomberman. Yay.
Yeah, they didn't show any Metroid.
No shit.
I miss Metroid.
And also, it's just sad because, like, I know there are fans out there that like Bomberman, and I know a lot of people were getting pretty hyped for Super Bomberman R, and now it comes out, and it's basically, like, an eShop title at full price, so I'm just like, oh, that sucks. Should you try again because you're fucking this up?
Don't doubt me, bro.
I can see out my eyes, he says, as he fails the mission terribly.
I can do it. Just keep talking.
I will also say that I worried that the Joy-Cons weren't going to be, like, durable or that, like, they wouldn't be comfortable. They're hella comfortable. And hella durable, even if they have, like, issues. Generally speaking, it doesn't feel like they're going to break in my hands, is what I'm trying to say.
At the same time, they're extremely fucking small.
They are, but I definitely just, like, something felt better about them than I expected. And I also, another thing is, like, for a while I was like, oh, who cares if you get the gray ones or the red and blue ones. Having felt both of them in my hands and seen them both, I kind of prefer the red and blue colors now.
Something is just wrong if they have no color to me.
No, they look cool if they have no color, but I think, because Dave, failed this. Just restart. Because Dave got the gray one. So I've held it in my hands, and actually I think something feels different between the red and blue ones and the gray ones.
Maybe it's feel.
Yeah. You are failing!
Matt, the Red Skull can't help you right now.
I know he can't, but still. You know what can help me?
Editing the Red Skull in so I don't sound like I just pulled a reference out of my ass.
What can help me is the Nintendo Switch.
When Mario comes out, that's all I'm playing.
Oh my god, when Mario comes out, we're not going to be doing any Let's Plays because, like, literally the only video that's going to be here is, like, it's going to start off with you, like, So guys, I know you've been wondering, where are the videos at? And then it's going to be showing me on the Switch playing Mario Odyssey. And then you'll be like, come on, Matt, we have to record Let's Plays. Mario Odyssey! Mario Odyssey!
We're suffering withdrawal.
You're going to be, like, trying to pull me away from it. And then we're going to be trying to record a Let's Play, and I'll just be playing Mario Odyssey while we're recording. I kid you not, I was actually considering, like, bringing the Switch up here with me and, like, playing it while we recorded just to see if I could stay focused.
You probably couldn't have.
Nope.
I mean, I can multitask. I can tell you that right now.
I can too, but, like, I feel
but
like...
But I can't play a video game and then watch someone else play a video game at the same time.
Like, I can, because, like, I sat on my laptop and, like, looked at stuff while we were doing Let's Plays. I actually do that most of the time, but I couldn't bring the Switch and Breath of the Wild up here and, like, play it while you're playing this, because I would be too focused on Zelda. This has been a Freedom Fighters Fail Reel, guest starring the Nintendo Switch discussion.
I see no editing in the future, so this is going to be a very boring video.
But our conversation's been solid.
Doesn't mean anything. I still want to see some stuff pop out of the screen.
There's really nothing I can put up that would be interesting.
How about you are failing? And I already said Red Skull.
No.
Or you can just edit some text in. Fail.
Maybe, I don't know. It is now time for Terrible Driving 101, starring Michael Anderson.
Or are we gonna start reading now, like SonicFanStories.exe or something like that?
Sonic.exe? No fucking way, dude.
And tell him to suck it, bitch.
And told his to suck it, bitch. He then went back to work on Sonic. Cock. That story is great, though.
Yeah.
Tails went down on Sonic and grabbed his package. You bunch of wankers. You big palooka.
I actually got called a palooka at work.
You did?
Yeah.
By a customer?
No, by a coworker. I was cleaning the toilet. Yeah, I know, I'm a janitor. Get over it. And Chuck came in, and he saw me come out of there giggling about how happy I wasn't up front. And he saw me, I looked dead at him, I'm like, with a big old teeth smile. And I waved at him goofily. He's like, Mikey Blue Gloves, you palooka. Well, at least I beat it.
Yay. And your car's about to explode.
Yeah, I'll just find something to fix it with. It's gotta be around here somewhere.
I also was kind of alluding to our next marathon when I said palooka.
Why?
Because it's Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah.
Well, now I'm not alluding to it. I just revealed it. Just outright. But don't you remember when they start off in Traverse Town?
Yeah, but that's the only time they say it.
What do you know, you big palooka?
Well, at the same time, that's not really helping people, because that's the only time anyone ever says palooka.
Even so, it's a line in the series.
At the same time, you can just say darkness, and people will know what you're talking about.
I'm sure I... Look at Lisa's eyes, by the way.
I know, right?
I imagine, like, you can literally look up online, like... I mean, I doubt it, but you can look up, what do you know, you big palooka, and you might find Kingdom Hearts.
Challenge accepted.
I'm about to do it. Here we go. I have my laptop right next to me.
Do it.
Wait, that's not Kingdom Hearts software. Oh, I typed Nintendo Switch into the search bar. That's why.
What? Womp womp.
I actually didn't type that. What do you know, you big palooka?
And then it's Joe Pesci.
Yeah, actually, the first video that popped up is called "You Big Palooka," and it's a Kingdom Hearts video. So, yeah. I'm not gonna play it loud, so I just wanna see. Yeah, the first video that pops up is that cutscene. And it has Donald saying, "What do you know, you big palooka?" So see, people will know what I'm talking about. Unless, because the second video that popped up was a song by Enrique Iglesias.
Huh?
I don't know. Are you guys playing a video game starring Enrique Iglesias or like with his music in it? No.
No, but I remember an episode of The Simpsons where Lady Gaga debuted.
Yeah, I remember it too, because I was watching it like last month. Or something like that.
It wasn't a bad episode.
No, it wasn't that bad.
I mean, I've seen worse.
I mean, the new stuff is apparently pretty bad.
Well, that's kind of what happens when your show runs for 30 plus years.
Isn't it true that when you start introducing new characters, that means your show is running out of ideas? Suddenly a new character appears in the living room.
Didn't fucking Cosmo himself say that?
Was it Cosmo? I thought it was a line from The Simpsons.
I need speed! More speed!
Very good, Lisa, because you're not doing a dent on that. Okay, there you go.
Yeah, it's because I'm not using a strong car.
Commentator's curse, because somehow I just said, like, you're not doing a dent, and then suddenly you just did, like,
you know what?
A solid amount of damage, and I was like, alright, yeah. Commentator's curse.
Hey, you're never going to be able to do that, he does it. Oh, wait, I'm going to shut up now.
But I'm going to tell the people what I told Mike earlier. I kind of hate that I'm seeing, like, Nintendo Switch commercials on YouTube with ARMS and Splatoon 2, but that there's still no release date for ARMS or Splatoon 2.
And I fucked up.
Because I really want to play ARMS and Splatoon 2.
Don't we all? Look at that. I was right the fuck done.
Yeah. But also because I played the campaign, quote-unquote, in Splatoon.
You played the campaign?
Yeah, didn't you?
Yeah, so did I.
And as short as it is, I think it's one of the best campaigns I've played in any video game. Real talk.
I mean, there's not a lot to it, and that's the best part.
The reason I say it's one of the best is because, literally, you know how, like, we talk about in some video games, Mafia 3, that you're doing the same thing over and over again? And it gets repetitive?
Yeah. Oh, let's get on a rant about that later.
I was playing Splatoon's campaign, and I think in, like, every single level, I was doing something different.
I mean, gameplay-wise, you're still doing the same thing, but at the same time, you gotta shoot and paint things differently than how you did it before, you know?
Yeah. Each level is teaching me something different, and I'm like, dude, this is fucking amazing.
That's what I like best about the single player.
And
get
I
you
think
ready for
I
the multiplayer.
I also attribute it to Nintendo, because Nintendo's level design is really great.
I don't think anyone makes better levels than Nintendo.
I don't know about that, but I'm just saying, like, they have a knack for level design. Like, I say that, like, because I'm playing Captain Toad right now. I remember when I first heard Captain Toad was, like, coming out, I was like, this looks like it'll be alright. I was never like, holy crap, this looks great. I was like, alright, Captain Toad. Cool.
Fuck.
And they're like, alright, a Captain Toad game. Huh, maybe it could be fun. And then you know what happened?
You played it and it was fun?
I played it and I really liked it because I remembered Nintendo's ability to create... Nintendo's knack for level design really shines because the level design in Captain Toad is really great. So that's why I think the game really, really worked.
Does it get called a poopy face?
Maybe.
Okay, if I can do that at least one more time, I'm sure I can get him.
I feel like that's like... Captain Toad for me has like the potential to become like... You know, way far in the future, when people look at the Wii U as, like, a cult system, kind of like what they do with the GameCube now, when we think about Wii U's hidden gems, I feel like Captain Toad's going to be one of them.
Captain Toad was a surprise hit for me.
Like, I feel like it's definitely... I don't know about surprise, because I felt like it was going to be good, just not, like, amazing. But I feel like in the far distant future, we're going to look at it as it's definitely going to achieve hidden gem status. Because I definitely think it was, like... Because it didn't sell nearly as well as, like, other Mario games on the Wii U or, like, other games on the Wii U. But it's a fun game, and I really enjoyed it. So I feel like people will one day look at it as a hidden gem. It also so happened that it was released in 2014 and was overshadowed by Mario Kart 8, Bayonetta 2, and Smash Brothers.
Hey, I'm just a little girl.
And to a lesser extent, Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze.
How far you get to wait for that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
sorry, I'm kind of sick of failing this mission, you know?
Sorry.
Yeah, I know. You almost got it. You're searching for your brother who got abducted by aliens, but you still want him to be blamed for a car crash?
It's a video game.
Based on a children's TV show. Well, not children.
Children? Yeah, sure. And now we believe that Homer is wrapping himself in a blanket, which gives him sexual powers. Hey, that's only a half-truth. Yeah, definitely for children.
I meant animated. Sorry. The animation age ghetto got to me.
The what?
The animation age ghetto. People believing that all animation is for kids.
Hold up, sausage party. Yeah, hi, hello, how you doing?
No, but, like, there's, like, a literal, like... That's an example of animation getting out of the ghetto. Because the animation ghetto is just, like... The... Wow. That... Being in the animation ghetto... That's basically, like, the thought process that if it's animated, it's gotta be kitty.
I need a ride here.
So, Sausage Party is the perfect example of them getting out of the ghetto. Stop texting.
Shut up, Jesus.
You shut up.
I'm not doing it again. I'm really not.
No, you shut up.
Bark.
Oh, real mature. No, you shut up. No, you. No, you. No, you. Oh, real much. Sure.
Don't give up, Homer. You're so close to your goal. But where do I go?
Much obliged. Thank you, Boob Lady.
It actually didn't appear until season 22 in the show itself.
So what do we do now?
How long do we have to do this? Until you have an epiphany.
Didn't they do it again in the show? Because that's what I was trying to
reference. For a really quick second. For the longest time, it was the only time they actually, you know... It was the only time they actually referenced the movie in the show.
How long do we have to do this? Until you have an epiphany. Okay. What's an epiphany? A sudden realization of great truth.
Epiphany, okay. epiphany. Bananas are an excellent source of potassium.
Americans will never embrace soccer?
More than two shakes
you play was playing with yourself? You know they reference, like, I don't know if this is a reference to that, but there was a Good Charlotte song that talks about that.
What, more than two shakes and you're playing with yourself?
Uh-huh. Because you know that song, The Anthem? You've heard of it.
Yeah.
Don't wanna be just like you. What I'm saying is this. It was in Donkey Kong. Conga 2.
Yeah, it's a very good song.
At one point, like, after the second chorus, he says, shake it once, that's fine. Shake it twice, that's okay. Shake it three times, you're playing with yourself again.
He's turned into Mush Mouth.
Bars. Bars. He sounds like every rapper these days.
What's your favorite catchphrase? Kiss my grits.
Kiss my grits?
Your brain is even more broken than usual. All I can do is take you home.
So basically, Bart has turned into designer.
I guess.
You know, that rapper that's all like, that mumbles all the time and is always like, get. I tell you about him sometimes. He's bad.
And now, let's see.
Mysterious shape found in field. Confused yokel. Scratches head. Missing boy found safe. Mind erased. Pants soiled.
That's why Lisa got him a diaper. He shit himself. Ew.
Gross.
And now
I just wonder, did he, like, in the game, like, did he just say, like, random stuff? Was his script just, like, random words, or is it just, like, backwards talking?
It's probably just some random gibberish.
Like, I wonder if, like, he said something and then they, like, reversed it, or if he literally just said something random.
Well, I guess a quick Google search can hold the answers. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're now playing as Marge.
Homer, it's a temptation! Wouldn't a beer ever hurt everyone? Anyone. Oh, Homer, you don't know the half of it.
Yeah, like, really?
That was, like, one of the best rides I've ever been on. The Simpsons ride.
Yeah.
I'm scared, Dad! If you haven't been to the Simpsons ride, because it's at both Universals now. If you haven't been on the Simpsons ride, do yourself a favor, because it's freaking great. Ooh, a roller coaster!
I'm scared, Dad!
Sweetie, these amusement parks won't kill you as long as you have a dime left in your pocket.
Alright, folks. Just want to let you know right now, we are now playing as Marge, and we're back in level 1. Only this time, it's at night! Ooh! I shit you not, they did not think of any more hub worlds and just turned the first hub world into night. And we can come into Bart's room, but who cares about that?
But he wouldn't like that if you came in his room. Like, right now, he'd probably be like, my...
Well, he's not in his room right now. Well, right now, he's not even in his room. He's in the living room.
But if he found out you were in his room, he'd be like,
That's why we don't have to worry about it.
Wait, I was going to say, one line that he says in the Simpsons ride that I love is, you fools, you're about to die. You sound like my doctor. They changed the music.
Yeah, I love Marge's music. It's nice, smooth jazz pieces.
You'd think that would be Lisa's.
No, Lisa had some jazz, but this is like nice, cool, relaxed kind of stuff.
I mean, I don't know what kind of music Marge listens to, because I'm not as big in the show, so...
Marge listens to anything she likes. She's like our mother.
I don't want to imagine her listening to modern-day pop, though.
Yeah. Well, remember, Marge is that person who has a problem with everything.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm sorry, but since this is not to my taste, I don't think anyone else should enjoy it. That was the best line she ever said.
I'm like, that sounds like the opinion of the internet.
It was for a good cause, though. Well, here's the thing. Marge is overbearing.
Yes, very.
But she is a good person at the end of the day. You know that. Mm. That's her character. She's like our mother. Yeah, you're overbearing, but at the end of the day, you're our mother. You're a good person. But the problem is, like, she tries to make everything perfect, like she said in the video games, in the game. Why can't some video games just be about sharing?
Because that would be boring. And honestly, even the more violent ones can be about sharing.
Here, you can have this cut, I'll take this cut.
Greetings, fellow Springfielder. I think you have backwards feet.
What?
I don't get it.
But also, video games are all about sharing these days. Like, especially if you have a PS4. Because then, there's no used game restrictions.
Thank you.
Little Ralphie
Whip.
Little Ralphie Whip.
Weren't you just over there? Why are you over here now?
Clowns are got sneezes.
Just give me the race.
6, 12, 1, go!
Great counting, though.
Wait, why am I racing the time DeLorean?
I am so
famous. I don't know. But that was some great counting.
Oh, it's Ralph, Matt.
6, 12, 1, go!
You'll never catch me!
But, what was I saying? Yeah, video games are all about sharing, especially if you have a PS4. Because if you have an Xbox One, there's no sharing whatsoever. Fuck your used games. You already played it once, can't play it, you're locked out. Have to beat everything you play in one sitting. Because eventually, once you use it, you're locked out of playing it from your own Xbox One.
6, 12, 1, go!
That's the joke. You suck, McBain!
You do that so terribly.
Well, you do it then.
That's the joke.
You suck, McBain! He throws a grenade in the crowd. Then someone else says something shitty about him, and he starts shooting everybody.
Is he supposed to be like a spoof of Schwarzenegger?
Yeah, of course he is. McBain is a... He is Schwarzenegger in the show.
Screw you!
It costs... It's just me standing behind a brick wall for an hour and a half. It costs $33 million to make. How do you sleep at night? On a large pile of money surrounded by beautiful women.
Beautiful women. This is just like winning an Oscar.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, how the hell do you know what that's like?
Yeah, Sylvester Stallone's sitting there like... Because, like, they hated each other for a while, so it's like...
I don't think they ever liked each other.
Well, I mean, now they do, because they've done movies together.
Doesn't mean you gotta like somebody.
Still, I mean, if they can work together, they must like each other now.
Yeah.
And I think they mostly only hated each other because they were the big action movie stars of the 80s, and, like, it was a battle of which one was better. Now that they're both kind of irrelevant, it's not really a battle of who's better.
So I don't really think they're irrelevant, it's just that they're past their prime.
They're irrelevant by today's standards in that, like, they can't lift a blockbuster movie anymore. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Their mantle of big action movie star has been passed down to, like, Jason Statham, I think.
Anybody who's not them, that's it.
But now they must not... I don't think they hate each other, really.
Maybe they only hate each other for publicity.
Probably. But, like, it was definitely, like, Arnold Schwarzenegger, like, he's getting sworn out of office. This is like winning an Oscar! Sylvester Stallone's over there going...
Yeah, you don't know what it's like to win an Oscar, so, what you talking about? Oh, and you sucked as governor. Just saying.
He really did, didn't he?
Steady wins the race.
Yeah, I have no idea, actually, if he sucked as governor. I just know that,
Oh, he had someone suck for him.
But
thank you, and good night.
Yeah! All I know is that he was banging the maid.
Yep, that's what I... Wow, thanks. I was trying to be subtle.
Fuck subtlety. I didn't need any kind of subtlety.
He fucked Maria, the maid.
Was that her name, Maria?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, wait.
Because they all made jokes about it on the internet. Arnold's new screaming quote, "Oh, yeah, Maria! Oh, yeah!" It's the name of the maid.
What were you doing before you were out there? I was governor. I was banging the maid and I ruined the state.
Yeah, break out of prison for a living, right?
I was referencing Jeremy Johnson.
Yeah. In all honesty, my whole life, I thought that was just Sylvester Stallone's shtick that he talked like that. Like, I will one day hear his real voice, but then I found out, oh, I get it. He was born with half a paralyzed face, so he's gotta talk like that.
Yeah. And, you know, I gotta give props to Sylvester because...
Yes!
Last year, I think it was... He was nominated for an Oscar for acting.
Yeah, it was for Creed, right?
Creed, yeah. So, I mean, you know, he was basically the laughing stock of the Razzies, and then he suddenly got nominated for an Oscar. So, I mean, in my eyes, you gotta give him props there.
Yeah. Creed made me cry.
I didn't see Creed.
See Creed.
Okay. I didn't see Creed. See Creed.
I'm not kidding. It's like one of those really deep feels kind of movies. Well, first off, let's get one thing out of the way. It's a Rocky Balboa movie in universe only. Like, it's not about Rocky. It's straight up about Creed. And it's Bastard Child.
Bastard Child is in literal Bastard Child?
He's literally a Bastard Child. We find out that Apollo Creed actually had an affair. And he's the child he never knew about.
Oh, because I was going to say, is it, like, literally Bastard Child, or is it, like, he's such a jerk that you just want to call
oh,
him?
Oh, no, he's... I love... Andolas, I think his name is? Andolas?
The actor or the character?
The character.
Oh, because I was going to say, the actor is Michael B. Jordan.
Yeah, Michael B. Jordan's a great guy, all things considered.
Great actor, you mean?
Yeah.
How you know what he's like as a guy? Have you met him?
No, but I just assume with all the good kind of parts he plays, like...
Yeah, he played the Human Torch.
I mean, when he starts...
What a good part.
Do you mind if I spoil it just a little bit at the beginning?
No, because for the people.
Alright.
It's not even just for me, it's for the people.
I mean, nothing he ever does in Creed is outright mean, malicious.
Malicious, you mean?
Vicious or malicious. I guess both. I was trying to say both.
Congratulations, you made up another word.
At the very least, you understand what I'm saying. He's not a bad person, is the thing. He's just a guy who wants to do life the way he does it.
Yeah, I know you.
He's extremely respectful, too, I'll tell you that.
You know, I always joked, because, like, the first time I heard Michael B. Jordan was in 2014, because he was in a movie called That Awkward Moment.
That Awkward Moment?
It also had Zac Efron.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. I just recently saw that movie.
It was, like, a really, really early year movie.
Yeah, and it was pretty funny.
And it was funny, because when I first heard his name was Michael B. Jordan, I always called him Michael, not to be confused with the basketball player, Jordan.
Yeah. Oh, now that it's nighttime for some odd reason, we can actually enter Mr. Burns' house.
Yay!
Let's trash this guy's stuff.
Are there any gags and stuff in here?
There should be, actually.
Okay, good. Then not all the gags and all the wasps.
Yeah, it would have been a real annoying piece of shit if they made us have to do all the gags all over again, you know? Now, this is an area I could have gotten to when I was playing as Homer, but I chose not to. Because it's actually connected to the power plant.
Was there anything to do?
Nope.
Because I was about to say, I remember this area being the game, and I was like, why didn't you go to it?
Because here's the thing. This is all it was. Like, this, and then the little chess guys right here. Little. But in this particular area, now there's wasps here.
So it's important.
Yeah, so it is important. It's collectible important, you know?
If you want 100%. Now, are those eyes in the pawns?
Yeah, that's the thing. Mr. Burns made a giant human chessboard. And all the chess pieces are people dressed up as pieces of chess.
So is he like, he's holding people hostage?
It's Mr. Burns, dude.
Still.
Remember, that's everything he does is excellent.
That's jerk-ass even by his standards.
Excellent.
Oh yeah, he wants to be jerk-ass.
Excellent.
Stop that!
I'm sorry.
Sorry. That was like spot on, Smithers.
When you've heard the voice for so long, you just try to keep on doing it until you can do it as well as you can.
That was like me with that's me with a couple of different people.
Like me with when I told you about my best friend Joe. One awkward cut later.
Yeah, sorry, I forgot that the camera has like a 29-minute, 50-second limit and I wasn't keeping track of how long we were taking.
That's the best part about having off-topic conversations, you just lose track of time.
Yeah, and you guys missed my amazing joke that I made.
About quoting Nicolas Cage?
No.
I'm sorry, hold on, before
No, it's not that joke. They did miss my impersonation.
Hold on, before we leave. There was a card in that room, in Mr. Burns' room I was just in, and a wasp. You get the card by pressing the Mr. Burns head.
Well, they did miss my impersonation, but that's not the joke that I was talking about!
I'm sorry.
The joke that they missed was, at one point, the wasp stung him. And then after it stung him, the frame rate went up. So I was like, holy crap, getting stung by a wasp makes the frame rate better.
You also lose money.
But the frame rate gets better.
So the frame rate gets better.
So it works out in the end.
Yeah.
But like, I think...
Realism, what the fuck is that?
Because since we were talking about like impersonations and stuff that I wanted to get down, one of them that I loved was Cartman. That was one I kind of learned like really, really quickly and just like... went along with.
That's because also, I think you knew of South Park, you just never were into it.
I don't really know this show, and I don't watch the show at all, and I only really knew it because I saw you play the Stick of Truth. But I kind of just figured out that Cartman just had like a really fast and annoying voice, so it was easy to impersonate, to do an impression of that. And I feel like since I'm talking about it, the people will want to hear my impression, so...
Just say a couple of lines. Don't start the whole Cosmo's a bitch song.
I won't start the song, Mike. I just want to say a couple things. I just want to say I'm really thankful for the people for watching this video. Thank you very much, and enjoy. See? Kept it quick. See, that wasn't a bad impersonation, was it?
Nope. Oh my god! They killed Kenny!
You bastards! I always tell my, like, coworkers that, like, I want to randomly, like, talk to a customer in a Nicolas Cage voice and see if they, like, if any of them are fooled.
You know what? I'm not going to lie to you. When I'm in the drive... Does that thing give me coins?
Guess not.
When I'm in the drive-thru, I put on a different voice with every single customer. Because if I mess something up and they come back and say, hey, I want to talk to that Aussie guy who just took my order but messed up my quarter pounder meal.
Talk to them in like an accent like, so you wanted the 10-piece nugget with fries and a soda. And then they come back and you're just like, I want to talk to that Australian guy that messed up my order. Oh, I'm so sorry. He just left to go on his break. Do you want me to tell him something for you? Just like talk in a completely different voice and just see what they think.
Yes, like that. I love it.
Oh, and I just have one thing to tell you. I'm also that guy who had the accent that messed up your order.
One of my biggest tips about work, no matter where you are, always have a positive attitude. No need to bring sourness to work.
Yeah, having a sense of humor also helps.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I'm too cringy. And I'm just the dork.
At least it's not cringeworthy Adam Sandler comedy.
I'm Adam Sandler, I'm gonna talk like this, you know?
Yeah.
Cautiously, wildly accelerating.
I want a tamako.
I think the only Adam Sandler movie I've seen in its entirety was 8 Crazy Nights.
Really?
Yeah.
You haven't even seen Happy Gilmore?
I've seen bits and pieces. I haven't seen the whole thing.
You gotta fucking see Happy Gilmore, dude.
I kind of don't want to because my thoughts on Adam Sandler have really soured.
Well, here's the thing. That's one of his earliest works, and that one's like, it's a classic, that one. That one and Daddy's Boy. Daddy's Boy, I love Daddy's Boy.
I thought it was called Big Daddy.
Oh yeah, I'm thinking. I might be thinking of another one.
Cause Big Daddy was the one with the DVD cover where they were peeing on the walls.
Yeah, fucking hilarious.
I've seen bits and pieces of that as well. Otherwise, I'm not a big Adam Sandler guy. Something about his humor, I'm just like no.
It's because it's child humor is the thing.
It's child humor made for an adult audience.
In all honesty, his movies are, and I can't believe I'm quoting the Nostalgia Critic here. His movies are an excuse for him to go on vacation.
It's always how I look at it. And I like, it's so sad because like we were watching 8 Crazy Nights in school.
Why in the world would they show you that fucking movie in school?
My teacher, Mr. Weingarten, thought it would be like a decent movie to show off. Like because we were about to leave for like Christmas break, and he thought it'd be cool to, cause he's Jewish, and he wanted to show like a Hanukkah movie, so he showed that, and I was like, Christ Almighty, this is bad.
Did he kind of notice, like, as he was watching it, that I may have fucked up here?
No, because, like, people were laughing at it. It's not like it was a completely insensitive movie, because he personally thought it was funny, and people were laughing. I was just sitting there like...
This is racist.
Racist? The fuck?
Rob Schneider.
That, but I wasn't focused on that. I was just like, oh my god, this movie's complete shit. Yeah. I was, like, sitting there facepalming, like, what the fuck was Adam Sandler on when he made this? It's not good. Like, sometimes I ask what Seth Rogen is on because, like, he makes something funny that's, like, really, really weird. Adam Sandler is taking the wrong kind of drug. Adam Sandler is not taking what Seth Rogen is taking.
It's weird, too, because, like, that's an animated Seth Farland, I was gonna say.
Seth Farland?
Yeah, you fucked me up right there. I was gonna say, that's an animated Adam Sandler movie. And I think it would have cost him less money if he just did it in live action, you know?
I don't know, I think... It probably would have been even worse if it was live action.
In my opinion, why didn't he make it live action? Why is this particular Adam Sandler movie the only one he ever made that was animated?
I don't know, because he thought kids would get off on toilet humor and the animation probably helped. No, because even though it bombed, it at least made a little bit of money. It probably would have made nothing if it wasn't for the animation.
You think?
Yeah, because it appealed to kids.
Oh yeah, sure.
Though I do debate if it appealed to kids when Adam Sandler literally sang a lyric at one point that went, "The only time I had sex was on the phone."
I feel bad for Whitey, I really do.
I think that was the only thing in that movie that made me laugh when he said that the first time. Even now, I'm just like, okay, that was funny because it was a shocker. Now I'm just like, dear God. Now my house just caught on fire.
What?
Honestly, if I could go back to that moment when I was in 10th grade watching that movie in high school, this is literally what it would be like. He would sing that lyric real quick.
And now my house has caught on fire. What?
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Because you hated him so much.
Sorry, just had to get that out of my system.
You can come stay with me for a little while, baby.
No, no. End movie.
I think I'll be fine. What other choice do you got, Rockefeller?
To end the movie now. He becomes a hobo and it's a Christmas miracle. The end.
It's a Christmas miracle that you have nothing?
It's a Hanukkah Christmas miracle thingy. Cause he was a jackass. What a Christmas miracle. He loses his home. The end.
Here's a question for you. When he brought him home, his sister says, "Who is this crazy person?" or something like that. "He's his Davey. Did he come here to molest you?" I'm like, why would you ask something
Stop pausing.
Like that? No, I had an itch on my nose. That was my fault.
I'll just be like,
"Did he come here to molest you? Why do you ask a person that?"
"Did he come here to molest you?" Can we end the movie now, please? We've only just met this character, and I already hate her.
At least she sounds like a different character.
I don't care. It's literally like, that would be my commentary throughout the whole movie. We should make like a video. I mean, we can't with this camera because it's only like 29 minutes and 50 seconds.
That because I don't want to get copyright infringement.
A video of my commentary throughout the movie, because I would be riffing on it so hard.
Let it come up. You would be that kind of dick who puts its head underwater and doesn't let it come up for air.
It was a bad movie.
I know. I'm not gonna act like it was a great movie because it's not. It's not a great movie.
I would kick it while it was down. While it's down though.
I'll say this now.
It would be sad. It would be like people would like hate me forever. Like even if they hate the movie, they would be like, "Dude, you are an asshole." And I'd be like, "I'm really sorry. I can't help it sometimes."
I'll say this right now though. Better than Jack and Jill.
I mean, you're comparing, like...
You're comparing shit to puke, I know.
You're comparing a giant block of tofu that has nothing on it to, like, fucking coleslaw.
To
Brussels sprouts or something.
So, either way, I'm comparing shit with puke.
Yeah, essentially. It would be, like, so... I would be angry the whole time. What other options do you got, Rockefeller, to end the movie now?
Well, at least there are some funny jokes.
I was such a shithead, you know, for kids. But Whitey never quit on me. Except for the part where he was like, "You're not welcome in my house."
Well, that wasn't until later in the movie, so.
Same exact gag here.
Yeah, there's no one who can ever win that minigame.
Though it's funny because Marge and Homer play it the exact same way.
Maybe you would care to eat what's in the mystery box.
And like I said, the gags are all the same.
Isn't there one more costume to get? Because you should get it here.
I'm missing one fucking... Fuck me! I hate when it's just one! Like earlier today, when you're playing Captain Toad, you had that one coin that could have got you the extra mission.
Yeah, don't remind me.
Okay, but I don't want to get caught with another accident like that again.
Shut up. Stop trying to quote Monsters, Inc. It's Dream Team.
Hey, at least, at the very least, it's better than quoting 8 Crazy Nights.
Let's see what this does.
Come on, you got agreement with me there.
Yeah.
Yes!
Hey, I can't fault you for that.
I can't argue with that. I would say that we should replay Scream Team because of the quality of the old one, but I just got done playing that with Wayside. Or rather, I got done playing it 5 months ago and it just got uploaded now.
Okay. This is not gonna turn into...
No, I'm dead serious because, like, literally I was rewatching the Let's Play and even though the audio was shit throughout it...
Not bad.
Not that it was, like, complete shit, it's just, like, I guess... Because Dave wanted to shut me up and upload the video for once, he forgot to, like... lower the game audio, so it was sometimes really hard to hear our commentary, which sucked because Kenny and I had some quality jokes about Dave's uploading skills or lack thereof. But it's
funny. That's too bad. You couldn't hear yourself rant about Dave.
But it's funny because I think 90% of my commentary throughout the whole Let's Play was talking about Dave and his ability to upload videos or lack of ability thereof.
Yippee!
I mean, it was mostly in part 5, but, like, you can hear me talking about it in, like, literally every single part of the Let's Play. It was bad. But it had to be said. It had to be said.
That's what I say about that.
I didn't say it just to, like, make Dave feel bad or anything. I said it because I had to.
It had to be done. Dave's probably rolling around in his bed right now like someone's talking shit about me.
About my uploading.
Sound like Dave, not Captain Kirk.
Shit. Talk about my uploading skills. He wakes up like sweat dripping down his head.
Yeah. Skills or lack thereof of skills.
Kenny and I talked to him in private about it just recently because, like, it was pissing us off that much.
I feel you.
Because I don't want to talk too much about it because I don't want to turn into a rant. But at one point in the...
Sorry, I got a cramp.
In part 5 of Scream Team, he basically said, like, you know it's never going to get uploaded. And I was like, then you're doing the people a disservice. And he said, it's not for the people. It's there for me. And then that's when I kind of felt like... Listening to that over and over, I felt like hearing that made me feel like a puppet, pretty much.
He sounded like a dickhead when he said that.
Like I was just bending to his will. And, you know, when I went to do Let's Plays over at Wayside with them, I didn't go to be used as a puppet. I went so that we could keep the tradition of Freedom Fighters alive.
Even though Basically, Freedom Fighters is still kind of rising from the ashes.
You know what I mean. The spirit of... doing Let's Plays with Dave and Kenny, you know? So when I heard that, I was like, this is not what I wanted when I came here to... when I came here to do Let's Plays with you guys. So I had to, like, tell him that in private. Because I was like...
Well, now it's public, so fuck.
Like, I had forgotten that he said that until he finally uploaded the video, and then once I heard that, I thought about it, and I was like, wait a minute. So I'm like a puppet. I'm basically being used. Like, he just tied strings to me, and I turned into Pinocchio, and he was just like, dance.
Well, you're not really Pinocchio.
You know what I mean.
Pinocchio didn't have strings.
You know what I mean. He basically, like, I felt like I had strings tied to me, and I was just being told, dance for me.
All right. Man, breathe.
I'm breathing, don't worry. I'm just letting the people know what I had to say. So we had, so like, that's what we had to, like, tell Dave in, like, a conversation.
Well, wait the fuck? Hold on a second. I saw something.
Look at that. Wow.
What the hell?
Great programming. Wait, go to it.
I'm trying.
Because you know what I have to say about that? I think it's pretty radical.
Is that a bush in the sky?
I can't even tell.
That was fucking weird.
That was scary. I need speed. More speed. But yeah, it was... That was something that, like, last time we were with Dave, I had to get that off my chest to him. And it kind of worked because he started editing a video while we were there, but it still hasn't been uploaded. So...
Matt, knock it off.
I'm not gonna keep bashing. I'm just saying, like... Just saying... That was what I said that I felt had to be said. You know?
Yeah, I feel you.
And I feel like, to be completely honest with you, the fact that we started Let's Plays Up was kind of... Even though I didn't intend for it to be... Wow. Even though I'm sure we didn't intend for it to be like this, I feel like, subtly, it was a way of saying, I'm tired of the videos not being uploaded over at Wayside. Let's just do Let's Plays ourselves. You know? Steady, Marjorie, steady. You know what I mean?
Yes, man, I understand everything you're saying.
I mean, I'm sure that's not how we intended for it to be. We just wanted to get back into Let's Plays. But, that's just how I looked at it. More of, it's how I reflected on it. No hands! Look, Mom, no hands.
Alright, just breathe, it's over.
I know. Well, it's not over till they're uploaded.
Come think of it, he hasn't finished Doom yet, has he?
Nope.
Bet you $1 million we can finish Doom before he does.
I'll take that bet. I told him I want to start uploading the videos for him because it's like taking him too freaking long. There are parts of the Doom Let's Play that we filmed back in July that are still not up.
Those were the ones I was in, right?
Yeah.
Great, so, now I'm upset.
So you're a puppet too.
Well, I don't really appear in videos like you do.
But you're still a puppet.
Alright, this is gonna drive me to fucking drink.
Didn't it do that last time too?
Well, this time there's actually something up there. It's not just a shortcut.
I feel like once we get it or something, we should probably cut, like, pretty soon.
Yeah, I'm kind of, like, this is the last card, and I'm not really, I'm kind of tired now.
That and also we're on one bar of battery at, like, 20 minutes, and I have to edit 3 clips together.
All right, are we done for the night? Can we call it from here?
Sure, even though we really ended on a somber note talking about Dave's uploading.
Let's think of something funny.
The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild is an amazing game. Go play it.
Yeah! All right. Good night, everybody. See you later.
I don't think they heard you. Say it again.
Good night, everybody. I'll see you later.
Bye, guys. You can't see it, but I'm holding up the peace sign.
Peace.
See you guys.